Hey, it's Kurt at the Top Corner Hockey Studios, Top Corner Hockey on Facebook, Top Corner Kurt on Instagram. Thanks for watching. You gotta be flaky to be a goalie, right? I mean, they want to get hit. A National Hockey League puck weighs 6 ounces, it's frozen, vulcanized rubber, and it's regularly traveling at 100 kilometers an hour. On top of getting hit by pucks, goalies also have to deal with the opposition running them, sometimes their own defensemen and teammates falling on top of them, crushing them. And at the end of the day, they're the only one on the team that's measured by wins and losses. It's the toughest job in sports. And it can get worse, too. Now, on a good defensive team, a goalie might only see 20, 25 shots a game. But if you're playing for the doormat, that number can easily go to 30, 40 shots a game, and it can be all the time if you're the starter. It's a really difficult job to be eating so much puck all the time. And sometimes, now, whether you're the best team or the worst team, your teammates decide to take a night off. And instead of being the last line of defense, you're the only line of defense. And you get shelled. Inspired by Arizona Coyotes Mike Smith's incredible stand-on-your-head performance this past weekend against Columbus, here are my top 10 goaltending performances of all time. At number 10 is Tony Bruns. Going a little off the board with this one, Bruns is a senior at the Morris Benson High School in Morris, Minnesota. Bruns made 98 saves in 60 minutes and during a brutal 12-0 loss to Litchfield Dassel Cokato High School on November 26, 2016. This is a U.S. national single game record. Wow. Yeah, I know he lost the game and his goals against average took a big hit, and no doubt his save percentage was under 900, but 98 saves is 98 freaking saves, and that's a big game. Amazingly, Bruns said he had no idea he was eating so much puck. Talk about being in the zone or what? Number 9, one of the best goaltending duels this century happened at MSG. The Rangers and their rivals from across the Hudson met on January 12th, 2010. The game featured two of the best goalies in the game, Henrik Lundqvist and Martin Brodeur. The two All-Stars were both peppered. Lundqvist stopped 45 shots and Brodeur 51 through 65 minutes. Then Brodeur made 4 saves in the shootout before Patrick Elias scored on King Henry, give the Devils a 1-0 shootout win. It was the busiest of Martin Brodeur's 125 career shutouts. Number 8 is a game that I watched. It was the night Dwayne Roloson stole one from the Maple Leafs. Roloson was a late bloomer. After beginning his career bouncing between Calgary, Buffalo, and their minor pro teams, Roloson teamed up with Manny Fernandez in Minnesota to become the two-headed goaltending beast that impressed for a few years in the early 2000s. Roloson eventually went on to star with Edmonton and later Tampa Bay on impressive postseason runs. In between the Alberta Capital and the Florida Lightning Capital, Roloson spent 2 years on Long Island. On November 23, 2009, Roloson faced 61 Toronto shots and made 58 saves, getting the Islanders to overtime before Josh Bailey scored the winner. To say goaltending was the difference in this game is a giant, Hulk-sized understatement. While Roloson was kicking out 58 shots, the tremendous goaltending tandem Toronto had, Avesa Toskala and my name is Jonas Gustafsson, gave up 4 goals on a paltry 21 shots. Yeah, they were good. The only reason Roloson's night is not higher on this list is because Toronto goal scorers included Wayne Primeau and Nicholas Hagman. Number 7, New York Islanders' Glenn Healy had a beautiful performance on January 16, 1990 against Vancouver. Although these were the days before Pavel Bure was racing up and down GM Place, goals were still coming faster and more frequently back then than they are now. To give you an idea, the NHL save percentage in 1990 was 88%. These days, it's always over 91. In 89-90, when Healy shut out the Canucks, 8 players in the NHL scored over 50 goals that year, and 13 players had over 100 points. Last year, 1 player had over 100 points, and 1 player scored 50 goals. And last year, only 1 team had a collective save percentage under 9, and that was Calgary at 89%, still better than the league average in 1990. So put into perspective, Healy's 51 save shutout against Vancouver in 1990 may not be the highest shot total on this list, but it is absolutely worthy of a spot here. Number six, Mike Smith's 59 saves versus the Jackets this past Saturday night. What a night. But despite Smith's heroics, the Coyotes lost 3-2 in a shootout. The shots were 23-4 in the third period. Holy sauce! Someone checked the tape to make sure the Coyotes actually came out for the third. Smith must have been exhausted because he failed to make a save in the shootout as both Cam Atkinson and Sam Gagner scored on him to win it for Columbus. That's a tough way to lose. Smith did everything humanly possible to not walk away with 2 points hurts. Number five, it's not deja vu, but Mike Smith is back. The former Sudbury Wolf, Smith boarded up his net and set an NHL record on April 3rd of 2012 with an amazing 54 save shutout over Columbus. Unlike his wonderful game at number six, the Yotes got Smith a few goals. In this game, Arizona won the hockey game. But what's this with Mike Smith, the Coyotes, and Blue Jackets meeting up in the NHL history books? I mean, like, are they at the center of the space-time continuum?
Whoa, this is heavy.
Number four, when Ben Scrivens got traded from LA back home in 2014, he had no idea Edmonton would be so generous. Just 2 weeks after getting traded from La La Land, the Spruce Grove, Alberta native started against the San Jose Sharks. This is without question the greatest night Scrivens ever played. The former Big Red was peppered with 59 Shark shots. It was a feeding frenzy for sure, and Ben Scrivens stopped them all. 59 saves. I remember hearing about this performance and tuning in mid-game, rooting for Scrivens. I really wanted him actually to get to 60 shots. I shouldn't have been wishing for the guy to make more saves, but I was. It's the most well-earned shutout in NHL history. No goalie has ever faced so much rubber and cooked a bagel on the same night in the history of the National Hockey League. Not Patrick Waugh, not Martin Brodeur, Ben Scrivens. Wow. Here's another one I remember well. Ronnie Tugnutt of the Quebec Nordiques had the second best game of his life early in his career. I remember my buddy Venkman and I making fun of Ron's name when we were kids. But there's no teasing Tugnutt on the first day of spring in 1991. Occupying last place, as the Nords usually did in those days, Ray Bourque and the Boston Bruins took their Adams Division opponents and piled 73 shots at Tugnutt. Bourque himself rifled an NHL record 19 shots on the Quebec keeper. But Tugnutt was inhuman that night and made 70 saves over 65 minutes to earn the Nords a rare point in a 3-3 tie. I was just a kid and I remember reading about this and how incredible it sounded the day after. It's still just as unbelievable what Tugnutt did 25 years later. I say it's Tugnutt's second best game of his life because he was in goal for the third longest game in NHL history back in 2000, but a top 10 goalie playoff performances is another list. Number two, Sam Lupresti. A rookie tender with the Hawks during the 40-41 season, Lupresti set an NHL record making 80 saves against Boston on March 4th, 1941. Art Ross winner Bill Cowley, along with the dominant Krautline, Schmidt, Dumart, and Bauer, were a force to be reckoned with as the 41 Bruins were one of the best teams in NHL history. That awesome Bruins team also helped Lupresti establish another record that night. The rookie's 31 first period stops are also most in NHL history. What's more incredible is Lupresti only gave up 3 goals, but Chicago lost 3-2 to the first place and eventual Stanley Cup champion Bruins. 80 saves, my goodness. Unbelievably, there's still one better than that. Number one, of course, every goalie on this list was fabulous and in most cases stole the win for their team. First, second, and third star worthy for sure. One goalie who regularly did this during his career was Curtis Joseph. I've never seen a goalie steal games an entire playoff series like Cujo did. He was something else. He did it in St. Louis, he did it in Edmonton, he did it in Toronto, and multiple times, in fact, in each city. He really was something else, and he really was fun to watch. In 1996, the Detroit Red Wings were rewriting the NHL history books. The Wings won an NHL record 62 games that season, and during the year, St. Louis Blues coach Mike Keenan said the NHL should just give the Stanley Cup to the Wings. Cujo didn't see it the same way. On December 10, 1996, Joseph stopped 52 Red Wings shots in Detroit, and the Wings and Oilers skated to a 0-0 tie. Joseph stopped the likes of Yzerman, Fedorov, Lidstrom, Coffey, Cicerelli, Larionov, all of them in the Hockey Hall of Fame. Two-time 50-goal scorer Mickey Redmond was doing the color for the Wings that night, and he said it was the single greatest performance, not just by a goalie, but any player he had ever seen. And Redmond played on teams with Dryden, Worsley, Tony O, Vachon, Jackman. Those are his goalies. How do you think Chris Osgood must have felt at the other end? He's having a tea party back there making 21 saves, and yet they each get a shutout. Even the fans at the Joe gave Cujo a standing ovation because they knew he deserved it. What a night. This was a tough list to make. Any one of these guys in the top 10 could have been number one. Perhaps there are even more out there. Did you agree with everything else on the list? Perhaps you think that Lupresti's 80-save performance should have been automatically at number one. Perhaps there's even something else that I didn't think of. Please write your comments below. Please also continue to like and subscribe. I'm Kurt. This is Top Corner Hockey. Thanks for watching. See you next time.